This is part 3 of a series on recurrent neural networks. In this video, we will implement RNN models for time series forecasting. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI text-to-speech. In the previous video, we looked at the structure of many-to-one and many-to-many RNN models. In this video, we will implement them in code. First, let's implement a recurrent layer using Keras' custom layer and implement a many-to-one RNN model to predict time series. Next, let's implement a many-to-one RNN model using Keras SimpleRNN class. Keras SimpleRNN class makes it easy to implement RNN models. Finally, let's implement a many-to-many RNN model using Keras SimpleRNN class. Now let's create a recurrent layer with Keras custom layer and implement a many-to-one RNN model. Create a time series dataset. Let's generate two sine curves with different frequencies mixed with Gaussian noise as shown in the figure. Each curve consists of 1,000 data points. This data is a 1,000x2 matrix. This data has two features, X1 and X2. Each column vector is a sine curve. In this figure, the blue curve is the time series X1 and the orange curve is the time series X2. Our goal is to predict each time series into the future. We use this data to construct a dataset for a many-to-one RNN model. The number of time steps is set to 20, i.e. 20 time periods. The dataset looks like this. X-train has a 3D structure like this. And Y-train has a 2D structure like this. This dataset is for time series forecasting. Please refer to the first video in this series for how to construct this dataset. Now let's create an RNN model like this. This model consists of an input layer, a recurrent layer, and an output layer. The number of features is 2. So the number of neurons in the input layer is 2. Since we are going to predict the time series of each feature, we also have 2 target Y. Therefore, the number of neurons in the output layer is also 2. The number of neurons in the recurrent layer is set to 50. Since the number of time steps is 20, the recurrent layer is repeated 20 times. Next, let's write a class for recurrent layer using Keras custom layer. The name of this class is MySimpleRNN. It inherits from Keras's layer. It takes the number of features and the number of neurons as input. The recurrent layer has parameters WX, WH, and biases. Parameters WX and WH are initialized using Xavier-Glorot uniform. And all biases are initialized to 0. Create 2 TensorFlow variables for WX and WH as trainable parameters. WX by NFI-inch matrix and WH by NH matrix. NF is the number of features and NH is the number of hidden neurons. We also create a TensorFlow variable for the biases. These parameters are shared across all time steps. Next, we write the call method. This function takes data X as an input. If we unfold this network over 20 time steps, we get the following figure. The output of each time step is H. H is ANNH matrix. N is the batch size of the input data. And the NH is the number of neurons in the recurrent layer. The output of the previous step is fed into the next step. It is initialized to 0 since there is no previous step. Now, to find H for each time step, we repeat the following procedure for a given number of time steps. We use this formula to compute Z at time step T. And if we apply the activation function to Z, we get HT, which is the output of time step T. The hyperbolic tangent was used as the activation function. This H is the input for the next step. At the end of the iteration, it returns the final H. Since this RNN has a many-to-one structure, only the final output H is passed to the output layer. The final H contains all the information from the previous time steps. That is, it contains information about the sequence data from the past to the present. Now let's build an RNN model using this class. Create an input layer. The input layer will receive 3D data. The first dimension is the batch size of the data. The next dimension is 20, which is the number of time steps. And the last dimension is 2, which is the number of features in the data. Next, we create a recurrent layer using the class we just created above. Initiate the MySimpleRNN class by entering the number of features and the number of neurons, then feed X input into the class. This class returns the final H. Finally, we create an output layer. The number of neurons in the output layer is 2. The final output H of the recurrent layer is fed into the output layer. Here we use the linear activation function. This is because this model is for time series forecasting, so it's a regression problem. Create a model for training and compile it. We use the mean squared error loss function and the atom optimizer. And let's check the structure of this model. Fit this model to the training data. The batch size of the data is set to 50, and the number of iterations is set to 100. And visually observe the history of the losses. Next, let's use this model to predict future time series. Predict future values for the next 50 periods. Let's just plot the time series for the last 100 periods of the original data. This is the last 100 time series. Iterate over 50 periods to predict the next 50 time series values. Predict the next value with the last n step data points. If you feed the last n step data points into this model, the output y hat is the predicted value for the next time series. Append the predicted value to the last data array. In the next iteration, the predicted value is input along with the existing data points. If we repeat this 50 times, 50 predicted values will be appended to the last data array. The length of the last data array will be 150. The first 100 are past time series, and the last 50 are predicted future time series. P is the past time series, and F is the future time series. Now let's plot the past and future time series. Plot the past two time series in blue and red. And plot the two predicted future time series in green and orange. Let's check the results. Let's look at the structure of the model. There is an input layer, a recurrent layer, and an output layer. The parameters in the recurrent layer are WX, WH, and bias BH. WX is a 2x50 matrix, so it contains 100 elements. There are 50 biases. WH is a 50x50 matrix, so it contains 2500 elements. So the recurrent layer contains 2650 trainable parameters. This is independent of the number of the time steps, because they are shared across all time steps. The output layer contains 102 parameters in WO and BO matrices. This model contains a total of 2752 trainable parameters. And visually observe the history of the losses. You can see that the mean squared loss decreases significantly as training progresses. Finally, let's look at the past and predicted future time series. The blue and red are the observed past time series. You can see that each curve has some noise mixed in. The green and orange are the predicted future time series. You can see that two sine curves with different frequencies are predicted. You can also see that the noise has been removed. In this way, we can use recurrent neural networks to predict time series. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. Next, let's implement this many-to-one RNN model using Keras SimpleRNN class. Import Keras SimpleRNN class. We will create a recurrent layer using this class. The rest of the code is all identical to the previous code. Let's check the results. The number of trainable parameters in this model is 2,7,10,52, the same as the previous code. And the past and future time series are like this. The results are similar to the previous code. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. Finally, let's implement a many-to-many RNN model using Keras SimpleRNN class. Import SimpleRNN and time-distributed classes. Create a dataset for a many-to-many RNN model. This data, like the previous code, consists of two sine curves with different frequencies. X-Train has a 3D structure just like the previous code. But this time, Y-Train also has a 3D structure. This is because this is a dataset for a many-to-many model. Please refer to the second video in this series for how to construct this dataset. Now let's build a many-to-many RNN model like this. As with the many-to-one model, there is an input layer, a recurrent layer, and an output layer. However, unlike the many-to-one model, the output H of each time step is passed to the output layer. First, create an input layer. Then create a recurrent layer. To create a many-to-many model, we need to set the return sequences argument to true. This means that it returns the output H for each time step, which will be passed to the output layer. And then we use the time-distributed class to create the output layer in this way. This means that the output layer is distributed across each time step like this. The rest of the code is the same as the many-to-one code. This model outputs multiple y-hats from all time steps. Therefore, when predicting the next time series value, only the final output is used. let's check the results. The parameters of this model are also 2752, the same as the many-to-one model. The number of parameters is the same, only the network structure has changed. The past time series and the predicted future time series are as follows. The results are similar to the previous code. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. So far, we have implemented RNN models that predict time series. In the next video, we will look at long short-term memory, LSTM.